Hey everyone, in this video I will be comparing the newly launched Claude Sonnet 4.5 model along with Claude Opus 4.1 model for coding. So here I am having a bunch of HTML, CSS and JavaScript prompts, and along with that I am having some lead code problems. So let's get started. So first let's go with some HTML prompt, okay? And this is going to be my first prompt: HTML, CSS, JavaScript code to simulate leaves falling from a tree with randomized shapes and other stuff in a single file. Let's see what both these models gives for this. So we have got the output from Sonnet 4.5. So let me simply download this and open it. And damn, that looks so good. We are having the leaf controls, and we are also having a calculator over here that gives us the number of leaves in the air, I guess, and the number of leaves on the ground. So if I clear it all, add 50 leaves, damn, that looks so good. Add 10 leaves, if I just keep on clicking, add 50 leaves. Okay, that's crazy, that's good, that's not bad at all. It has literally done what I asked, and it has also given me some additional controls. So this is perfect, and as usual, Sonnet 4.5 has done an amazing job. Okay, this is the response that we got from Opus 4.1, and here I'm having a tree and leaves are populating from over here. Similar to that, we are having autumn color, we are also having the wind force, we are having a spawn rate, we are having an air drag, we are having spring colors and autumn colors. Okay, spring colors are more greenish and autumn colors are more brown and red in color. I really like this. If I increase the air drag, there is more influence. That's amazing. Damn, wind force. Yeah, there is now more wind force, as you can see, right? Damn, that looks pretty good from Opus 4.1, I would say. So what I feel is that Opus 4.1 has done a better job. Of course, in Sonnet 4.5, we had some customizable options like add leaves and clear, but it's so minimal when compared to what Opus 4.1 has given. Opus 4.1 has given the statistics, there is a tree, there are leaves, and it's also having a clear option, and it also has the autumn colors, spring colors, and other micro level controlling things. So I feel it's more customizable in Opus 4.1 when compared to Sonnet 4.5. But overall, both these models have given good responses. Next, let's go with a bit tough prompt, which is creating a big bird using HTML and also show the side view of the bird flying in one single file. This prompt may sound so simple, but executing it is so difficult. Most of the models have given bad outputs for this prompt. Let's see what both these models gives. Okay, we have got the response from Sonnet 4.5. Let me just open it. And this is what it's looking like. I mean, it has done a decent job in generating the bird. The cloud looks fine and only the eyes are somewhere else. And the interesting thing is, I tried the exact same prompt with it yesterday and it was giving me a good response. But now the response is like little bit distorted. But apart from that, it has done the work perfect 90%. Only this eye thing is quite bad. And let's see what 4.1 has given. Damn, that's a lot of birds. Let me open it. Okay, that bird looks perfect. Like, I guess this is literally the best a model has generated for this particular prompt, and the sun is also looking good. We have the clouds. So I would give literally like 200 out of 100 for this. That's how perfectly it has generated that wing movement, right? I mean, of course, this is just HTML, CSS and JavaScript. This is the maximum thing that you can generate, but yep, that looks so good. And I guess for this particular thing, I will go with Opus 4.1. It has done a terrific job. And next, let's go with this one. Simulate movement of planets around the sun, showing animation in a single file. We have got the output. Let's view it from Sonnet 4.5. And damn, we have got all the planets, but I just have a doubt. Why is everything spinning in the same orbit? Okay, we have the pause and play, speed up, speed down. Looks good, but the only thing is, why is everything spinning in the same thing? That's the only thing I find it weird. So let's see what Opus has done for this. and let me just download and open it. And this has also has got the similar mistake, like literally all the planets are going elsewhere. It's not even spinning in the correct orbit, it's just going somewhere else. So I think like both the models have failed to generate a good one for this. So now let's go with some lead code problems, and this is an extremely difficult problem, difficulty level hard with acceptance rate just 30%. So it's so difficult. Let's see what both these models does for this. So we have got the response from Sonnet 4.5. Let me copy it and just paste it. We don't need the int main. I'll just remove this. This is fine. Let me just submit it. And damn, it has got 100% in runtime, beats everything, and in memory it has got 53%. So that's really a good, you know, good submission from 4.5. And next, Opus has also got the response. So I will just copy this. Okay, this has also got 100%, but when it compares to the memory, I think 4.5 got 50%, but Opus 4.1 is not far away, got 40%. So Sonnet 4.5 wins over here. So let me go with this famous prompt, which is HTML that shows ball bouncing inside a spinning rectangle and it should be affected by gravity and friction. Okay, we have got the response from Claude Opus 4.1 for that ball spinning inside rectangle, and let me just copy this and paste it over here in the HTML viewer. Let me just open it in a new tab. Okay, this looks good, but I'm not sure why it is spinning inside a circle, because in the prompt I have clearly mentioned it as inside rectangle, right? But it's spinning inside a circle. But apart from that, we are having bounce loss, gravity, rotation speed. Okay, that's rotating so fast now. Okay, that's good. Okay, that's not bad, to be honest. Only thing is, I don't know why it's given me in a circle. That's the only big thing. Let's see what Sonnet has done. Sonnet has done an amazing job. 4.5, perfect. This is what I wanted, a rectangle and a ball spinning inside it. So as a conclusion, what I will say is, I think both the models really perform equally well enough, and in some cases 4.1 performed well, in some cases 4.5 is performing well. I think we'll be seeing a much difference when we are going to create some complex project or multiple agentic calling in Sonnet 4.5. But when compared to normal prompts like this, normal use cases like this, I really feel both these models are equally performing well. Do let me know in the comments what you think about it. That's the video, guys. Check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.